Welcome to Distorted Opinions. I'm Kayla. This week, I'm joined by Ted. And before we get started, I want to give a quick shout out to one of our new listeners who gave us a shout out recently on TikTok, actually, and also sent me an email recently with some show suggestions. So quick shout out to Jake Young, who is Jake_Young_ on TikTok. Definitely go check him out. And he's always posting videos about gear and music and guitar. Really, really cool stuff on his account. So thank you, Jake, for supporting the show and for reaching out with your suggestions. We were already discussing a few of them before the show started, and I think we've got some stuff to talk about in some future episodes.
You might be hearing one of those topics in the very near future.
Yes. So thank you again to Jake. And for this episode, Ted actually at our last jam session had mentioned to me that he had discovered this band through YouTube, correct?
I think. Oh, definitely YouTube.
Yeah. Yeah. Ted is, I find a lot of music through TikTok these days. Ted has all along been finding a lot of his music through YouTube. So
the algorithm is just dialed in. I don't know what's going on. I'm not complaining.
They know
but
you.
They
you should be a little concerned, I think.
But it's music. It's okay.
Yeah, true. True. It's when they start feeding you other videos, they get like, I get some videos sometimes I'm like, what led YouTube to think that I wanted to see like earwax removal video?
Oh, gross. Like, get out of here. No way.
I'm not even kidding you. So glad you're getting a much better feed of relevant content for you, because I'm not quite sure what led to stuff like that for me. So but
maybe I just scroll by it or just ignore it, and then they're like, oh, he's only here for music and two other channels, and that's it.
Yeah, feed him nothing else or he's not coming back.
That's so, right, pretty much.
Yeah. So they're like, here you go, here's a cool Swedish rock band.
That's right.
So the group that you had mentioned to me, and we were looking up how to pronounce their name before the show, and I think we're taking our best guess based on some very hasty research, that Soen. It's probably Soen.
S-O-E-N, Soen.
Yeah,
in Soen. The Swedish pronunciation.
Not to be mistaken with Soen, which is the bike company. Soen. So I would have pronounced it very differently if we hadn't looked that up. But these guys, so you've been listening to them for a while. I was just kind of cramming in listening to some of their stuff today while I was working, and really, really enjoyed what I was hearing from them. They've got an interesting mix of, I don't want to say soft rock because that's not the word I'm looking for, but they have some really heavy stuff, and then they have some stuff that's a little bit mellower. That's, I think, a very different sound.
It balances it out.
Yeah.
No, definitely the biggest appeal is certainly the heavy guitar, the drum. Mm. The drums in it are very good, and then the guitar solo and the way like. Just the solos that are in there, it hits the tunes that I used to listen to growing up, that just good guitar tone, slow guitar solo thing, and then brings it forward with good distortion in the heavier parts of the song. I also find it interesting, the vocalist has elements of a David Draiman.
I heard that too. Yeah, I was like, some of the songs I heard, I'm like, this is very Disturbed-esque,
right,
particularly
right.
On the vocals.
Correct. Yeah. No. Yeah. Definitely on the softer side, where they like only reference really is Sound of Silence and some of the tones that he gets in that song. This singer can pull off. I mean, elements, it's not exact, but you kind of get that vibe from those parts of the song. But definitely really good.
Yeah, I heard it was interesting because I was listening to it and it was like different songs. I would hear similarities to different other bands that I'm familiar with. But it was like every song that I listened to kind of had a different feel of some of those bands. So like I got disturbed, and then at points I got like it almost kind of sounded like Shine Down with the vocals. Yeah. I heard like some Volbeat in there a little bit too. And then I got a lot of like, oh, I wish I, because I was listening to it in the background while I was working, so I wasn't necessarily taking notes of which songs I was hearing. So unfortunately, I can't reference which ones, but there were definitely a few that I heard that I'm like, this really has some Tool vibes too. And it wasn't just the vocals, but like the bass, the drums. The
bass is prominent, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And like Tool or A Perfect Circle, actually that one I did note they had a song, EMDR, which I felt really had a lot of kind of the Tool vibes on it.
It's then, on the album that I purchased. I only have Imperial, which is their 2021 album.
I don't know which album that was off of, because it was kind of just playing through songs. I started with their popular songs. So actually the first song I listened to was Lotus. And that was off of not the album that you've got. It's off the self the title track off the album Lotus from 2019. And that was kind of more on the mellower side. And then I clicked over to I think it was Lucidity. And I was like, holy crap, this is totally different from that. Or is this, or it didn't start playing a song from a different band, did it? And it hadn't. It was just a even heavier track by the same band, which I thought was kind of interesting that they have that nice mix of a little bit of everything, I think. But yeah, I kind of listened just through starting with their most popular and letting it just play through, and it got to Illusion, which is off of the new album that you've been listening to. And that, to me, the guitar solos seemed like I got Pink Floyd vibes from the guitar solos on that. Like,
I could definitely hear that.
Yeah, really, really cool stuff. So yeah, I've been enjoying listening to their music immensely. I wish I had listened to it sooner when you first told me about it, but
that's all right.
Discovered them now, so listening to them now. But I know you've been listening to Imperial quite a bit since discovering the album, and you ended up purchasing it, as you mentioned. So
yeah, and just for listeners not familiar with the band, they are they are from Sweden, progressive rock group, which with the original lineup, it was the drummer of Opeth and Testament, bassist and, you know, vocalist and guitar player with them. And then the band members changed over time as, you know, the folks moved around. And just looking through the notes here, it says the Cognitive album, which came out in 2012, was mixed by David Bottrill, who also mixed Tool and Coheed and Cambria, Silverchair, and Muse, etc. So when you reference a Tool vibe, I wonder if, depending on what year the songs were that you were listening to, if he had that type of influence in there too. So
Yeah.
Interesting take.
And it was funny because I was thinking that as I was listening to it today, but then I pulled up Wikipedia to find out a bit more about them before we got started with the show. And they mentioned that they apparently have had reviewers note quite a bit that their style is similar to the music of Tool. To which Martin Lopez, who's their drummer, current drummer, commented that we are inspired by Tool, but I consider them not only a band, but a genre. Besides that, I really don't think there's anything to argue about. We make good music, whoever it would remind you of. Some people tend to dislike rather than like and are looking for faults instead of seeing music for what it is, good or bad. So apparently a lot of people have also made that connection that they're stuff sounds kind of like Tool.
And I don't always hear the tool. It's only on Tool elements, because to me, the especially the latest album is far more progressive, alternative ish type of vibe. But either way, it's the first song that came up on my list was I think it was Illusion, and then I wound up like, oh, this is good, and then I went to listen to something else, then I listened to the whole album on YouTube, and I was like, okay, I am sold. We'll be getting this one for sure. So I got this at the same time as Black Pumas.
Oh, nice.
While I was in there, I was like, yep, I'm gonna do this one and this one and this one.
Yeah.
So nice. It's just it's an interesting group, being a super group that is, I mean, Sweden makes some crazy good music, but certainly felt like this should have come up sooner in my periphery of Swedish music, because they're popular. they have a lot of views, and I'm like, where was this like 5 years ago? They've been around for a long time.
They've got a lot of listens over on Spotify too, like, you know, anywhere from a million up depending on the song. So it's not like they're fairly undiscovered rock band. These guys have been around for a bit. They've got a following and very good stuff. So yeah, I'm kind of with you on that. Like, where have these guys been?
Yeah.
Why are they not getting more play even on US radio? Because, you know, their stuff is very good, and I feel like
it's radio friendly, to be fair.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
it's not
exactly
like everything on that album is pretty radio friendly. So I don't know. It's funny how it all works. You know, production quality is on point. Like,
oh yeah,
it's not a question of it just maybe just general interest and
yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, they're touring Europe right now. Don't know if they ever do any tours in the U.S., but I know we have some people who listen in Europe, so perhaps this is an opportunity to go see them live somewhere near you. But I'll be listening to a lot more of their stuff, definitely, now that they're on my radar. And I haven't looked at any of the music videos, but I did see that they have a few music videos.
The music videos are also pretty good.
Are they?
I mean, in terms of...
you tend to be the music video, you know, you find them through YouTube, so
that's... Right. Yeah. Yep. Illusion music video is a bit tugging at heartstrings, given the way of, you know, it's more war torn, avoiding soldiers, and the dad with his daughter, and he goes off to get supplies and tells the girl to stay put, but then he doesn't come back, and it's very tugging at the heartstrings type of thing. But the other one that I watched, Monarch, this one's a bit more straightforward, just singer in front of clouds, and he's got a snake, and he's sitting in a throne, I don't know, a bit more straightforward for a music video, but good stuff all around. Yeah. I haven't watched the other couple, because they certainly have at least four others.
Oh, wow.
I haven't had a chance to look at yet. So, and then never mind all their live footage.
Yeah.
Oh, there's even more. I just keep on scrolling. I'm like, oh God, I didn't see that one yet either.
They've got quite a few albums out. Let's see, albums. So they've got, Lotus, the bonus edition, Imperial, which came out last year. Let's see, 3, 4, 5, 6. I guess 6 albums, but going back to 2012. So, I mean, they've been putting out music for 10 years now, and quite a few songs on each of these albums as well. But yeah, I haven't even listened to probably half of the stuff that they put out yet. And I think there's definitely a difference between their earlier stuff and their current stuff. I mean, it all.
They had changed turnover in bass and guitar since the beginning. So, certainly those are some big adjustments as as the music is played anyway. So would not be surprised with the change in tone or feel.
They've had four guitarists and three bass players. So, yeah. A variety of different styles there.
Yep.
Definitely worth giving them a listen if you haven't heard of them. Again, the spelling is S-O-E-N, and we think the pronunciation is Schwinn.
Schwinn. Something like that.
We forgot already. Yeah. S-O-E-N. Just look them up. You'll find them on...
The American pronunciation is Soen.
Yes, we apologize to the band for probably really butchering the name. I feel like the last couple of episodes, I spent a lot of time apologizing for mispronunciation of names, but that's why I always spelled them. Definitely well worth a listen. Great band. And I've been, doing my usual searching the TikTok late in the evening for all kinds of music stuff.
Yeah, you send a message like 11:30. I'm like, oh, look at this, a TikTok.
I'm hopeful that everybody has Do Not Disturb on their phones. Oh, God. Not.
It's fine.
Oh, geez. Well, I'll keep that in mind going forward. I know Keisha does because I get the silence notifications. But I don't always get that with a group message, so I never quite know. And it's like, I'm gonna limit it. Two texts is all I will send. that, and I know that you have to go through the whole sign-in process to be able to see things. But I've been sending some videos to you and Keisha and Matt. And one of the videos that came up is somebody that actually Ted, I knew I had seen this guy before, and I'm like, I feel like Ted sent some of his stuff on Instagram. Zeppelin Bernatra has some really great stuff. He plays all kinds of, it's not just guitar either. He plays like different types of guitar. He's got double neck guitars. There's a video here where he's got a harp guitar, which is a guitar neck on the bottom, and the top is just like this odd shape, kind of a rounded shape with a hole and like five strings that don't have any frets. So it's kind of like just the bass notes, I guess. He's got all kinds of stuff here. I could be here all day watching his stuff, but one of the videos that I saw over on TikTok was him playing Fingerstyle Under the Bridge by the Chili Peppers, which is very cool.
I found him as a recommendation on Instagram and immediately followed. And the guitar playing is immaculate because it's he can hold the main riff of the song on his left hand and do the voice part hammer tapping style on top with his right hand, and you get the full song between his two hands.
Yeah,
it is crazy.
Yeah,
and it's clean.
Yeah,
and it's always no effects or anything. It's just guitar being guitar by itself, plugged in. Yeah. Maybe it's acoustic, and it's he's done. I've seen him do Michael Jackson songs. I've seen him do a lot, everything. I feel like every time it's just like, oh, this major song nails it.
Yeah,
it's crazy how good he is.
Yeah, he's got a video here where he's playing Guns N' Roses finger style, and again, it's clean, and he's playing it on a Les Paul, and Live or Let Die There is some distortion there. I'm watching the video because I wanted to hear it. I saw it. And I'm like, so it starts out clean and then he puts a little distortion on, but it's still not like, it's not the way Guns N' Roses would play the song. You wouldn't hear Slash play it this way. He doesn't use a pick. Yeah, he's an incredible, incredible guitar player, but he also plays a variety of other stringed instruments, which is really cool to watch him play some of these, because he's a little bit like Marcin in the way that he plays guitar. It's almost like he plays it more like a piano because he's doing that tapping and a lot of just like hammer-ons and pull-offs. And I'm always impressed by that sort of thing, because you have to be a really clean player to begin with to be able to play like that. But you also can't hide behind effect pedals for like crappy playing. And I've said it before, a lot like with jazz guitar, you have to be a good, solid, foundational guitarist to begin with, because you're not hiding behind effects. And a lot of his stuff is that same way, because he's playing acoustic or he's playing clean or he's playing some sort of a stringed guitar like instrument that's not a regular electric guitar. Very, very cool stuff that I kind of revisited some of his stuff, which I had seen from you sharing over on Instagram. And then after I watched a couple, I was like, oh, right, I've seen this guy before.
I just haven't shared any of his videos in a while.
Right, exactly. So I had sent you guys some of his stuff, and then, like, I try to pick and choose what I'm going to send to, particularly send to a chain that has you on it, because the process is signing in. But there was this other guy that I found, I think it might have been last night that I sent it. Ricky Jab is his username.
I didn't get a chance to look at those yet.
Oh, okay. So
I have him in the queue of things to check out.
So backstory a bit on this is that we just had our jam session. And so one of our friends, Hogan, started playing My Heart Will Go On, which is totally unexpected at a jam session, but there it was. And Matt, who's not with us for this episode, showed up with a synthesizer and returned from wherever he had wandered off to about halfway through the song and started in with the synthesizer. And then the song ended and then it turned into like the rave version of My Heart Will Go On, which I'm like, boy. And actually Michelle in the background is like, that's the version that was playing when the Titanic sank, right? And like, yes, that's precisely.
If it sank 100 years later.
Uh-huh, yeah, the DJ was on the ship. So I saw this version that Ricky Jab posted that's like a collaboration with some other artists. And it's basically the metal version of My Heart Will Go On, but they left the Celine Dion vocals as well as they've got this vocalist who's like screaming the like death metal style. Very interesting way of covering the song. Highly worth giving a watch to. I kind of hope there's a full version somewhere, but this guy, he basically takes pop songs and turns them metal. So he does metal covers of well-known pop songs. And I don't remember, I think, which one of his videos, I don't remember which one of his videos popped up in my on my For You page that led me to him. But then next thing I knew, I was down the rabbit hole of having watched like 20 videos on his account. And then I sent a couple to you guys. I picked and chose some of the better ones. I almost sent you, I didn't watch this one, but apparently he did an emo version of a Rascal Flatts song, which I saw the thumbnail and I was like, oh, I should watch that and see if it's worth sending to Ted, because this might be a country song that Ted might be like, oh, this isn't bad. oh my goodness. I'm listening to it now and actually it's quite good. I think I'm gonna have to send it to you.
Fair.
Yes. So if you're interested in seeing some, I guess, metalized covers of pop songs and country songs and things that are not otherwise metal, definitely give this guy give his stuff a watch. Ricky Jab. He's also, I believe, got some stuff on Spotify, because usually what I do, as I've mentioned before, is if I see somebody who has some cool stuff on TikTok that I like, I'll go look them up on Spotify and see if they have music there and give their stuff a listen. Actually, he does. And so this was another really cool cover he did. I am not familiar with the, I believe it's a movie. It's either a movie or game, Interstellar.
That's the movie.
Is it a movie? Yeah, that's the movie. As we know, I don't watch a lot of movies, so it could be...
It's the movie.
It could be anything, and I wouldn't know that it was a movie. But anyway, yes, I guess it is a movie with Matthew McConaughey and Anne Hathaway and some pretty well-known movie actor and actresses are in that. So anyway, he does a cover of, I guess, the theme song from that that's really cool to hear on a guitar. And then he does a J-Rock version of Light Switch. Light Switch J-Rock, I guess it's called. So yeah, he's got some cool stuff on TikTok as well, or Spotify. So if you want to, if you're not on TikTok and you want to listen to some of his stuff, that's maybe another way to do it. But yeah, he popped up yesterday and I was like, okay, this guy's doing some cool stuff. I always like hearing some of these like crossover genres of, you know, the song in one genre and now somebody's covering it this other way, and very cool stuff there too. So that's just a little highlight of some of the stuff that I found recently, because there's been plenty more stuff, and at this point I don't even remember all of the stuff that I have sent to you guys over the last week or so. But lots of stuff, a lot of bass videos, because for some reason I get fed a lot of videos of bass players on TikTok lately, which, not complaining, I've seen some really cool stuff, some really talented bass players over there too. But yeah, as always, good stuff on TikTok and in the music world. Anyway, I don't really veer too much outside of the music and the art world when I'm on that platform, but I always like getting to hear the cool music that's out there and discovering new stuff. So I've got a pretty eclectic, I call it my TikTok finds playlist over on Spotify, and it's like all over the place with everything from folk to kind of hip hop to R&B and heavy metal, and you name it, it's on there.
You know what? We're talking about discovering new stuff and have been for the past couple of episodes. What about rediscovering old stuff? Mm-hmm. Stuff that we used to listen to and you forgot, and then you hear it again and you know all the words, but you don't know where those words were stored because you haven't needed to call on that information for 20 years.
Yeah.
I'm talking about Incubus. I'm talking about the Science album in particular that came out in 1997. I don't know where I was, but one of their songs came on in like the background of a video I was watching, and my brain just lit up. I was like, oh, I forgot about that album. And so I immediately pulled up the full album on YouTube and just started running through. And I'm like, oh man, I had the CD. It was a burned copy. I don't know where it went. I thought I had all my CDs in a row. This one just evaporated somewhere. But again, burned copy, whatever. Mm-hmm. So another one I also picked up in my latest acquisition run is that album. And man, it's funkier than I remember in a lot of ways. Mm-hmm. There are certain tracks, and hearing it now, as opposed to what I remember then, some parts are like, wow, this is funky. This came out in 97. Like, man, all right, that's pretty good. And then, you know, just the classic hits. Anti-Gravity, Certain Shade of Green, oof, absolute banger tunes. So that one came back around. Really pleased.
Yeah. I don't know if I've heard I have to have heard some of the songs off that
album.
I know
you have, because we were hanging out and that was definitely on the CD player somewhere. It was probably my burned copy. It's probably in your CD player somewhere.
Maybe. I mean, I've still got all my CDs. Yeah, I just, none of the titles are standing out to me at the moment, but I'd like, so Make Yourself, I've like ton of songs off of there that I'm like, oh yeah, I remember these. These are kind of, I think, maybe the more well-known, but I'll have to listen to some of them.
But if you don't, I mean, none of the song titles jumped out at me either. But again, I only had the burned copy. So my exposure to what I didn't, and not listening to words, we did more on the music. And I didn't care what the titles were. I just threw it in because it was a good album. But you start playing to some of those songs and you're like, oh, I forgot about that. That one was a nice, pleasant surprise. To call back in.
That is, I heard Incubus. I think I was listening to the grunge station on Sirius XM the other day, and they were playing one of their songs. I was like, oh man, this is a throwback to high school. I haven't heard this one in a while. They had some really great songs that I completely forgot about, because you don't hear them a lot on the radio these days. So it's not like you're hopping in the car and it's like, oh, well, there's, Stellar or, you know, Make Yourself or any one of the Pardon Me was really getting a lot of radio play back around that time. I feel like Make Yourself and Morning View were probably two of their more well-known albums, because Morning View had Nice to Know You and Wish You Were Here. Oh man, yeah, this is like memory lane here, looking at this stuff. I mean, it's always fun to hear a song that's like, oh, I haven't heard this in forever, and then you go back and you listen. It's like, oh, they had this tune too. Oh, and this one. And next thing you know,
this is still holding up now.
This is still good.
All right. Yeah,
definitely. So it's funny that you mentioned that, because I keep seeing posts on Facebook for Life of Agony, and I'm trying to remember the name of the song. I've been meaning to go look it up on Spotify to find the song, because they had a song that was out. Wow, they've been around for a while. But they had a song that was getting a ton of airplay in like the mid 2000s that I can, whenever I see them pop up in my feed, I'm like, I hear the song in my head, but I can't think of the name of the song. I'm pretty sure it was Life of Agony. I'm going to feel weird if it was not Life of Agony and I keep associating that song with them every time. Wicked Ways, I think, was the name of the song. When did that come up? It was released in 2005 off the album Broken Valley. I think that's probably really the only song of theirs that I'm familiar with, but it's one of those that I see the name of the band and that's the song that immediately pops into my head. And I'm like, that was a good tune. I haven't heard that in a while. I need to go look that up and add it to my playlist, which is exactly what I'm going to do now, because I don't want to forget the name of the song. But that got a lot of play on my playlist back in the day. Yeah, there have been a few of those. Like, actually, the week leading up to the jam session, I was breaking out some of the classics, and I don't know what led me to, I'm like, Candlebox, Far Behind is another one that I'm like, I haven't heard this song in a long time. And actually, I think what led me to want to learn to play that was I saw somebody on TikTok playing that, and I'm like, man, I haven't heard anybody play that song. Actually, I don't think I've seen anybody play that song on social media ever. But it's a good song, and I remember learning the guitar on it back in the day, and I haven't played it in forever. So I was like, you know what, I'm gonna bring this one up and learn how to play it. So that one's another one of those that's like, and they're one of those bands that, again, I think they're really only known for that particular song. I think they had one other song that was fairly well known that got a lot of radio play. They had a couple now that I'm looking. See, now we've gone down the rabbit hole of like, well, they had this one song, but then it turns out they had this other one and this other one. You is the second song I know of that was really popular with them. And then Cover Me, I think I've heard before. But they're all off of the same album, and I don't know that they put out more than one album. Actually, they did put out more than one album.
Oh no.
Happy Pills in 98, but most of their most well-known songs came off of their self-titled album, which came out in 1993. And I don't know any of the songs that are on this album from 98, so, and they've got like not a lot of plays on any of the, I mean, in the grand scheme, not a lot of plays on any of those songs, whereas like Far Behind's got 104 million plays, so much more well-known, I think, than any of their other songs. Yeah, boy, that's a rabbit hole that I could go down all night.
Yeah. Another one that, so as much as I love Pantera, I wound up just getting like the greatest hits. And then the album, dude's getting punched in the face, Vulgar Display of Power.
Oh yeah.
So yep. Between Greatest Hits, Vulgar Display of Power, those are my Pantera tunes. And yep. Then the person on Twitch, Krebelstar, who does guitar yeah. video playing from time to time, yep. plays a lot of Pantera, which I love.
Yeah.
And he was playing a bunch of stuff and reminded me, I'm like, oh, there's a lot of other good songs off of Cowboys from Hell that came out in 1990 that I was like, oh, I need to get the rest of this album because the greatest hits doesn't cover that. Primal Concrete Sledge, phenomenal. Art of Shredding, phenomenal. And amongst everything else, I mean, Cemetery Gates is on Greatest Hits and yeah. everyone knows that song anyway, but and then Cowboys from Hell, the title track, obviously, but just having the Art of Shredding and Primal Concrete Sledge. I've listened to Primal Concrete Sledge at least once a week for like 6, 7, 8 weeks. Nice. It's just a good nice. Song. So happy I picked that one up just recently. And then another one that I just picked up is the new Mastodon, which came out last year, Hushed and Grim. Just because it's Mastodon. It's to me, Mastodon is a jam band. Like their songs have direction and focus, but it just sometimes feels like it's just loose in that it's just turned into a jam in the middle. And then they come back in and actually, you know, if the song ends. But I feel like a lot of their albums is just, it just sounds like people just hanging out and having a great time making good music.
Yeah.
As opposed to very calculated and dialed in, like, this is the way the song is going to progress. And, you know, there's an intent behind it. This is just more, it feels like go with the flow. I don't know.
Right.
To me. So like I enjoy Mastodon albums for that reason.
The metal version of the Grateful Dead or something, where they're like the jam band of the metal genre.
I suppose.
Not a comparison I ever thought I would use ever. That's
the strangest comparison I've ever heard.
But, like intense flute. That's two shows in a row where I've been like, those aren't words I ever thought would leave my mouth in the same sentence.
Yeah, leave it to this show to come up with something crazy like that. But
I guess so.
Yeah, no, that the new Mastodon album was pretty good.
Nice.
I still love The Hunter. Emperor of Sands album's phenomenal, probably my favorite of the more recent albums, but I just have to listen to the new one enough to really let it bounce around the brain and become fully attached. But two listens start to end, really like it. So
nice.
Yeah, definitely good stuff. Nice. I just haven't listened to it enough to have it all be glued in and be like, I want to listen to this, this is my favorite. It's not my favorite yet.
Right. Right.
Going to take some time.
Yeah. 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 It's so, yeah. The actually, one thing I did want to bring up. So I saw before we got started earlier that you sent a message to Matt and I, Matt and Keisha and I over on Instagram about the John 5 posted the tour that's coming up this summer.
Yeah, Rob Zombie posted the same thing.
Did he?
Yeah.
I was kind of chuckling because the comments, you were like, what year is it? And that was like early 2000, according to that lineup. So speaking of throwbacks,
there's a crazy throwback list.
Yeah, Rob Zombie, Mudvayne, Static X, and Power Man 5000. That's like,
yeah,
totally looks like a concert that would have happened when we were in high school.
Oh, yeah.
100%.
I've met Power Man 5000. I've met Static X with Wayne. I have a photo with Wayne on my wall, just on the other side of this.
Shown it in one of the episodes where we talked about our concerts. It was like one of the early episodes.
Yep. I've seen Static X 3 times. Mm. I've seen Mudvayne 2x and Rob Zombie 3 times. Yeah. Mm. I saw him with Ozzy, saw him with Manson, and I saw him with Alice Cooper.
Nice.
So yeah, I've seen Zombie 3 times, but he is a performer.
Sure.
I would love to see him again. I was nice. Talking about it not even 6 months ago. I'm like, it would love to go see him. Just the stage performance is second to none. It's outrageous good.
So what you're saying is you'll be getting tickets to the show.
See, but the hard part is I want to go to shows that I have for bands that I haven't seen. I know obviously Static X lineup is a little different. I'm not sure what, I haven't seen anything with their new singer or how that would all play out. So that one, new Power Man, not that great. It's not like mid-2000 Power Man where it was like on point with Stars Collide. Sure. And they were super good. And if I recall correctly, the drummer of Power Man 5000 is the brother of Rob Zombie.
Okay.
I think some weird fact like that. In Mudvayne, Mudvayne's put out new music supposedly, so I'm not surprised.
Yeah,
I know. I just feel like I've seen them all so many times that sure. I'm like, do I really want to go to that one? Like, I've got other shows I'm excited to see bands this year that I'm haven't seen before, and there's a show at the Middle East in Boston that I want to go see, which is a extreme metal band. There are a couple of bands that I really like, but I don't know. I didn't quite jump out at me because I saw that lineup and I'm like, that's a crazy lineup. But I'm like, I've seen it.
Yeah.
And I've seen them all at least 2x.
Sure.
So it's not like, I don't know, it would just be a newer rendition of it. That's all. Mm-hmm. And I'm not sure I want to do that.
Right.
This year anyway.
Sure. Yeah. No, I get it. I mean, personally, if there was a show that I'd want to go see this year, the Boston Calling show looks like it's going to have a pretty insane lineup. It's 3 days long, but tickets, especially for
every year,
all 3 days,
stupid.
It's like, insanely expensive. And let's be serious. The only day that I'd really be interested in, Sunday. And I'm sure our audience, if they go look up who's playing on Sunday, they quickly see why, because the headlining band is Metallica, and there's also some other interesting bands that I've heard of that are playing. So like Weezer's playing on Sunday with them, Glass Animals, Modest House. I've heard of both of them, or Modest Mouse. I've heard of them.
Is it the day Black Pumas is performing too? Or are they playing Saturday?
No, Black Pumas is playing on. When are they playing? I'm not seeing them.
I know they're playing it somewhere in there.
They're playing on Saturday. So the Strokes are headlining Saturday. And I don't know any of the other bands that are playing other than Black Pumas on Saturday. But Friday, actually, I know a number of the bands. So Foo Fighters are headlining the Friday show. And they've got Rufus Du Sol, Avril Lavigne, I didn't even realize she was still like touring and producing music, but okay.
I just go there for, you know, on the music that was made before. I don't know if she's making anything new either. I have no idea.
Yeah, I don't know. And I've never really been a big fan, so I'm not about to look her up and find out if she's putting out new stuff, because I probably won't really like it. I didn't like any of her stuff before. But Cheap Trick is also playing that night. The Backseat Lovers, I've heard of them. They're pretty good. The Chelsea Curve, I think I've heard of them. Haim, H-A-I-M. I'm pretty sure I've heard of Haim. So, I mean, there's some pretty good groups, at least, like, groups that I've heard of that I wouldn't mind seeing playing on Friday. Really, the Sunday show, I'd only mostly be interested in seeing Metallica. And it's just, it's a lot of money. I looked at tickets and it was like 300 and something per day, I thought. And that was not even, like, that's general admission. It's $370.
Oh, yeah. Goes up from there.
Yeah. Two-day general admission somehow. Oh, that's three-day general admission. Okay. So.
Still.
Yeah. One day is $130. Hmm. So that's, I'm kind of like, yeah, that's a lot of money. And just to see, like, there's only really one band I'm interested in seeing that day. Honestly, the Friday show has more bands that I would be interested in seeing, but it's also a holiday weekend. I'm probably gonna have family in town, so that kind of gives me a reason to not spend that kind of money on going to that show.
Yeah, and then speaking of other shows, Megadeth and Lamb of God and In Flames,
yes,
which is it's a good Sun lineup, right? They'll be at Mohegan Sun, yeah.
Yeah.
But obviously that tour is just coming out on too.
Sure.
But yeah, no, I think it's kind of funny. And Chris Adler, in my background here, is the original drummer of Lamb of God, who I know filled in for Megadeth's album at one point, did session drumming with them. Yeah. And then he's no longer the drummer of the band.
Right.
But I'm not surprised that the two are together, because they had that connection for a period of time and they'd already toured together once or twice. So, no, that one is looking pretty good. I'm a sucker for Lamb of God. Anytime they're around, I'm more than happy to go see them. I've only seen them three times, I think. But yeah, no, that one is looking pretty good too. But I already have two, possibly three, and then never mind. I don't even know when that show is at Mohegan Sun for a fourth. So a lot of shows this year that we're getting back to normal.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. No, definitely. There's so much good stuff happening. It's like, oh God, my wallet. I would love to see the Megadeth show. I'm really bummed. I think Megadeth and Anthrax both played at the House of Blues 2 or 3 years ago, and I didn't find out about it until after it had already happened. And I was like, oh man, come on.
I saw Lamb of God was at Mohegan Sun, and Anthrax was on before them.
Yeah.
It was that crazy show. The craziest lineup. It was Testament, Anthrax, Lamb of God, Slayer. It was Slayer's last show. And Behemoth.
Okay. Nice.
What a show. Holy moly.
Yeah.
That was awesome. It was such a good show. Arguably the strongest lineup in recent years that I've, for anything I've been to or seen.
Wow.
I mean, like, I don't know. That's pretty good.
Nice.
It was a good show.
Nice.
So, I haven't been to Mohegan Sun in a while, since before the pandemic anyway. So I'm like, Lamb of God show up at Mohegan Sun, maybe. Who knows?
Nice. Well, you'll have to let us know if you decide to go to that. Yeah. Nice. So I think we might want to move into Song of the Week, and I didn't even think to, I assume you had a Song of the Week picked.
Because I do.
Didn't ask you about that, but
I know how this show works.
Yeah,
we've done 94 of them.
I kind of figured I don't need to remind you, but hey, so as a reminder to our audience, if you are new to the show or if you just need the reminder, we have a Spotify Song of the Week playlist. We put that in the description of every episode, and we put our Song of the Week picks into that each week. So if you hear little snippet of whatever song we're talking about today and you want to hear the whole song, be sure to head over and check out the playlist. We have all of our past picks in there as well. If you're watching the video version of the show, we put the Spotify scan code up on the screen. All you have to do is open Spotify on your phone or mobile device, tap the camera icon in the search bar, and hold your device up to the screen. It'll take you right to the playlist where you should favorite it so that you have it moving forward, because we add our songs to it, and we've got a ton of songs in there from... What did we say? What episode is this? 94. So 94 weeks worth of songs, mostly give or take, because we don't do them for our gear talks, but there are a lot of songs in there, and it's a very eclectic list. So check it out. On that note, my pick, I went with somebody we didn't talk about today, but it does kind of tie into that, like, nostalgia factor of, ooh, I haven't heard that song in a while. So I opened up TikTok earlier to look for another artist that I was going to talk about on the show, and then quickly got sidetracked because the first thing that popped up was this guy Christian French playing a cover of Outkast's Hey Yeah. But it was like really cool because it was just him with a Strat, just clean Strat, playing some real laid back guitar, singing in a totally different style from the original song. And I was like, ooh, I wonder if this guy's got this as like the full version over on Spotify or something, which he did not, but he had many requests for people to put out the full cover of it, which led me to, in the comments, somebody said, go listen to the Obadiah Parker cover of Hey Ya solo version off of 2008's The Tip Jar Volume 1. So, of course, I went over and checked that out. And it's an acoustic cover, so it's just acoustic guitar and vocals. And because it's just acoustic guitar and vocals, you pay, or at least I, speaking for myself, paid a bit more attention to the lyrics, which I don't know how many people have ever paid attention to the lyrics of Hey Ya, because I think most people hear Hey Ya, the original, and it's like this really upbeat song that you tend to hear a lot at dances and weddings and parties because it's upbeat and people want to get up and move when they hear it. The lyrics are really, like, when you really listen to them and pay attention, are not all that upbeat. They're actually like the exact opposite.
Let me some sugar. I am your neighbor.
I mean, I listened to them and I'm like, what exactly is this song about? So of course, then I went and looked them up, and it turns out apparently, like a year or two ago, there were a lot of people that noticed this because I guess there were some memes or something that were getting posted with excerpts of the lyrics, which was causing people to be like, oh, what? I don't remember the song being like this. And it really is. It's about modern day relationships and how people stay in them because they don't want to be alone, not because they love the other person. Huh. Which is like, that's not ever the takeaway I would have gotten from that song, because I've never paid attention to the lyrics when I've heard the original. But you put it in an acoustic version where all you've got's the vocals and a guitar, and it's suddenly a very different story where it doesn't seem as upbeat and peppy as the original version does. So I thought that was really interesting, but it is a cool cover. I really enjoyed it. It went into my playlist. I hope this guy... Christian French does a full version of his cover of it, because that's a really cool cover that he was doing, but this one is equally as cool. This guy, Obadiah Parker, also does a cover of Al Green's Let's Stay Together acoustic, which is really cool too. So highly recommend checking that out. But my pick for this week is Obadiah Parker's cover of Hey Ya solo version. And So that's going to be my pick for the week. And Ted, I got to guess that maybe I can guess what band you're going to pick, but
probably correct. Let's see. Incubus. Incubus, A Certain Shade of Green, because that song has been stuck in my head since I revisited that Science album. Yep. And it is things that I forget about 1997 Incubus. The bass of that song is early Mudvayne crazy. Mm. It's got the new metal DJ rap skip record scratch on the background. Yeah. But what's funny is sitting around waiting till 2012 AD. Well, back in the day, it felt like it was far away, and now it's already 10 years after that. So
yeah.
To go back to 2012, I suppose. Just a great, catchy tune. A nostalgia for sure. But again, the peppiness, the catchy chorus, and then the just having crazy bass, and everything, that the whole mix works really well. So that's why it's my pick for this week.
Nice.
So, phenomenal.
Oof. Not what I thought you were going to pick, to be honest. I thought you were going to go with Schwen.
No, not today.
All right. Well, we spent like a half hour on it.
I'm sure people are going to go listen to it on their own, too. Hopefully they will. Yeah, it's true.
Yes. Well, that is a good pick. Definitely a throwback pick. Very good. And on that note, as a reminder, this is episode 94. We have been announcing the last few shows that at episode 104, which is 10 episodes away, we're going to take a bit of a hiatus because we've been doing the show for 2 years straight. Weekly. without like any breaks of shows. There have been breaks in there, but not like... But we made sure to continuously put out a show every week. So we'll be taking a hiatus, but if you have ideas for future shows or if you want to be on a show, whether it's before we go on the hiatus or maybe if you'd like to be involved on a show when we return from the hiatus, reach out and let us know. There are a lot of different ways you can get a hold of us. The easiest way to find us is to just go to our link tree, which is linktr.ee/distortedopinions. We've got the links to all of our social media, our emails in there. Let's see what else. Our anchor page where you can leave us a voicemail if you want. All the platforms we're on an audio only format. And our YouTube is in there. Be sure to go subscribe on YouTube because we're still trying to get to 100 subscribers so that we can get a custom handle over on YouTube. So there's a lot of different ways to get a hold of us that you can find them all at linktr.ee/distortedopinions. And on that note, thank you for joining us. Thank you for supporting us. If you've been supporting the show all along, we appreciate it. If you're new to the show, we appreciate you checking us out. And sorry if you're just now discovering us, but there's a whole backlog of shows, hopefully, that can keep you busy for a little while. And we'll hopefully be coming back after the hiatus with even more shows and hopefully some, you know, we've been talking about maybe some in-person episodes and those sorts of things.
Recording these in one, like all together in the same room, because we've only done this over Zoom for all these years. Right. And it's weird because it's years plural at this point because it's more than one. Yeah. Do like a round table, like, I don't know, I'll call together.
Pizza hut table at Ted's, in Ted's basement. Yeah. So, yes, we hope to be coming back with a whole bunch of new episodes and a renewed energy. So, in the meantime, reach out if you've got ideas or want to be on a show. And thank you for supporting us. Thank you, Ted, for joining me to talk about all kinds of different music-related things we talked about this episode.
We'll do it again next week.
Yes, we will. So, on that note, join us next week. We'll have a whole new episode. We'll see you then.